تذكر تذكر كلما
Remember,
صليت
every
ليلا
time you pray at
ليلا
night, millions chew
فالنور
rocks as bread.
على
On
جسر
the bridge of
الجراح
pain
مشت
it
ولمت
walks. It wears its skin and dies in
وتلبس
honor.
جلدها وتموت عزة. تذكر قبل أن
Remember,
تغفو
before
على
falling
أي
asleep
وسادة.
on any pillow, do they sleep, those who slaughter the country?
أينام الليل من ذبحوا بلادا؟ قلبي
If I
على
die in
جرح
honor or
الملائكة
loneliness,
النوارس.
my death will be a birth. I see them
إني
coming back
أراهم
from the
عائدين
churches,
من المدارس.
residing in the cities
فاست
and
جبينهم
churches.
المآذن والكنائس.
I see them coming back from schools, their foreheads kissed by minarets and churches.
لبوا لهم هذا النداء.
Give them this calling. Your conscience has dried. But not the tears of the innocent.
I met a woman, her mother and her son, all under the subtle shade of a tent. Three generations held together in one morsel of time. The life of a refugee is counted in moments. In this moment, we were bird watching on Lesbos Island, the sun melting clouds across our vision. As the first bird spiraled brilliantly toward the Aegean shore. To go from bird watching to boat watching in Greece is to witness the world unfurl. I was told of days when the birds came in hordes, broken winged and heaving, spilling forth 50 to 80 hatchlings at a time, each broken shell another person seeking rest. Floating rubber albatrosses, box-figured crows hug the horizon in the bitter cold. When an island becomes a door, who will answer? If enough eyes see a body in the water and no hands reach out to rescue her, did she really die? This time, when the world left infants to take their first steps at the edge of humanity, when the seams broke and the threads lay society bare, the eyes came and the helping hands followed. Imagine rivers full of people carrying people on their backs. Imagine shores covered in footprints and wheelchair tracks. The passion it takes to swallow the wind, kiss the October sea, and meet the boats. I've seen how paperwork can divide families, separating mother and father with the stroke of a pen. How firm handshakes can unravel entire nations when the stage is big enough. If I had the power, I would have papier-mâché'd those contracts. I would have lined the walls with paper cup lights. I would have painted the ceiling cerulean so even the smallest of palms could reach for the sky. I would have lined entire rooms with books and kitchens with the warmest pies. I would have carpeted camps with chalk to build a home, to make a refuge, to bring the dignity back into a concrete oasis. I would have built a camp that is a call to prayer, where a man who is carried in can leave walking. This is what I saw on Lesbos Island.